maybe the Celtics should yell at each other more often. After losing the first two games of the Eastern Conference Finals and having a locker room blowout after Game 2, the Celtics led Game 3 wire to wire and held off the Heat for a 117-106 win on Saturday night. Boston looked great for about 44 minutes and then held off a late Miami run to make it a 2-1 series. Strong defense led to some easy looks for the Celtics, and anytime Miami cut into their double-digit lead they were able to answer, hanging on until the very end. Jaylen Brown was magnificent for Boston and led the charge with 26 points, while Jason Tatum had 25 points, 14 rebounds and 8 assists. Kemba Walker scored 21, while Marcus Smart added 20 points. Gordon Hayward returned to action for the first time since Boston's first game of the playoffs and scored 6 points, pulled down 5 rebounds and dished out 4 assists over 31 minutes. The Celtics built a 12-point lead early in the second quarter, but Miami came storming back when Tyler Herro refused to miss. The Heat closed it to 3 when a frustrated Tatum was hit with a technical, and it looked like the Celtics would once again crumble after building an early advantage. But Boston instead buckled down and played some smothering defense, which led to some easy buckets in transition. Tatum answered with an angry driving dunk off a Brown block, throwing Jay Crowder out of the club in the process to make it 42-37. Tatum then returned the favor to Brown, feeding the swingman off a defensive rebound for a dunk of his own. Brown followed with a driving 2 off a steal at midcourt, and Marcus Smart capped off a 9-0 Boston run with a bucket off another Celtics theft. It took roughly 90 seconds for the Celtics to turn a 51-48 lead into a 60-48 advantage. Kemba Walker canned a 3 in the final minute of the half to give Boston a 63-50 lead at the break. The Celtics built their lead to 19, but struggled at the end of the third quarter, as they have done these last two series. An 11-1 Miami run cut it to a 9-point game until Walker hit a jumper to slow that momentum, putting the Celtics up 84-73. The lead was back up to 16 when the Celtics rattled off a 7-0 run over a 35-second span, capped off with Tatum turning a Hayward steal into a 3-point play off another dunk. Boston won the third, 26-25, and led 89-74 heading into the fourth quarter. The lead ballooned to 20, Boston's biggest lead of the series, when Smart aggressively attacked the basket and got fouled as he put in a layup midway through the fourth. His free throw giving the Celtics a 180 lead. A few plays later, Brown caused another turnover by Crowder at midcourt and threw it down for another easy 2. Duncan Robinson 3 broke up 15 straight misses from downtown for Miami and cut the Boston lead to 14. But the Celtics again had an answer, with Walker driving to the hoop for an easy layup, giving Boston a 104-88 lead with 5 minutes to play. But Miami went on another mini run, cutting the lead to 10 after Duncan Robinson hit a 3, and a pair of Crowder free throws made it a 104-94 game with 3:27 to play. The Celtics again answered, with Hayward finding Walker for a corner 3 to give Boston a 107-94 lead. Robinson cut it to 109-101 with another 3 with 1:12 to go, and it got a little more interesting when Brown was whistled for an offensive foul for putting an elbow into Robinson's face on the other end. That led to a flagrant 1 on Brown, 2 free throws for Robinson and Miami got the ball. Robinson hit one of his 2 freebies, and Bam Adebayo made an easy bucket to make it a 109-104 game with 55.9 left. Smart hit 2 free throws on the other end to give the Celtics a 7-point lead with 46.9 to go. He hit 2 more freebies with 28 seconds left to seal the win. The two teams now get a few nights off, with Game 4 scheduled for Wednesday night.